Today I am discussing about the different types of solar radiation. The sun is the hot sphere of gas heated by nuclear fission reactions at its center. Every second the sun emits a total energy flux of about 4×10⁻²⁷ kilowatt, out of which only a very small fraction is reached to the earth. So solar radiation is an electromagnetic radiation emitted by the sun. The radiation can be converted into useful form of energy such as the electricity, heat, etc. Now, today I am discussing about the different types of solar radiation. So there are three types of solar radiation at present. First is the direct radiation or beam radiation. Next one is the diffuse radiation. And third one is the reflected radiation. So in case of direct radiation, the light coming from the sun is directly fall on the earth surface. In case of reflected radiation, the reflected part of the light is coming to the surface, and in case of diffuse radiation, the light is diffused by the cloud or the moisture in the atmosphere. After that, the diffused light is passing through the earth level. Now actually what is the direct or beam radiation? Direct or beam radiation is denoted by IB. Direct radiation is received from the sun rays traveling in the sunlight line from the sun to earth. That means solar radiation received on the surface of the earth without changing its direction. Direct radiation is also, so these are the direct radiation where there will be no change of the dimension or angle of the radiation. The sunlight is directly coming from the earth to the surface of the land. So like this. Now direct radiation is also termed as the beam radiation or direct beam radiation, as direct radiation is sun ray traveling in the sun straight line shadow of the object which comes in the way of the sun rays. The shadow indicates the presence of direct radiations. In sunny regions and during summer, direct radiation accounts for the almost 70-80% of the total radiation is present. So maximum radiation is coming from the direct radiation. So because in this radiation, the sun rays directly coming from the sun to the earth surface. In solar plant, solar tracking is the very vital to absorb the most of the direct radiation. So solar panel, in case of solar panel direct, so this is the direct sunlight which is coming from the sun directly to the solar panel, and solar panel adjust the maximum amount of direct radiation light. Now the diffuse radiation, which is denoted by ID, its way through the atmosphere, it is absorbed, scattered or reflected by dust, water vapor, cloud, etc. The solar radiation received from the sun after its direction has been changed by reflection and scattering by atmosphere is known as the diffuse radiation. Diffuse radiation does not have any fixed direction. So because the radiation is totally diffused from the surface, so no particular radiation is dimension is present in this radiation, because this is the scattered, this is the result of the scattered of the sunlight by the cloud, water vapor, dust, etc. So does not have fixed direction of this type of radiations. In this radiation, shadow of the object will not develop. At pollution increases, the amount of diffuse radiation also goes up, because this type of radiation occurs due to the vapor, due to the dust, etc. So pollution is proportional to this type of radiation. In hilly area and during winter, the percentage of diffused radiations goes up. Maximum amount of diffused radiation is captured by the solar panel when they are kept in horizontal. So if we place the solar panel in horizontal direction, then the maximum captured light is coming from the diffused radiation. That means in case of solar panel which are at an angle to track the most of the direct radiations. So if we can place a solar panel in proper direction, then the maximum radiation coming from the solar panel is direct or beam radiation. If we place the panel in horizontal plane, then the maximum radiation coming from the sun is the diffused radiation. Now, last one is called the reflected radiation. Reflected radiation is the component of radiations which is reflected from surface other than the particles. The radiation reflected from hills, trees, house, water bodies, etc. is the reflected radiation. Reflected radiation generally accounts for the small percent of the global radiation, but can contribute as much as 15% in some regions. So these are the three types of radiations. These are the diffused radiation, these are the direct radiation, and these are the reflected radiation. Now, the total radiation denoted by IT, the sum of direct diffused radiation and the is incorporated at the surface of the earth per unit area of a location is known as the total radiation. So total radiation is mathematically represented by IT equals to IB plus ID. That is, total radiation is the combination of direct radiation and diffused radiation. Reflected radiation is negligible here because only a small amount portion of radiation is coming from reflected radiation. Now the ratio of direct and diffused radiation. When the sky is clear and the sun is very high in the sky, direct radiation is around 85% of the total radiation or insolation striking the ground, and the diffused radiation is about 15%. Now the calculation part of the radiation. Now the solar flux or solar radiation is leaving to the surface of the sun is given by Stefan Boltzmann law when the temperature is known as H is equals to L into sigma into T to the power 4, where L is the emissivity of the object, and let sun is the black body, then L equals to 1. Sigma equals to Stefan Boltzmann's constant, that is equals to 5.67 into 10 to the power minus 8 watt per meter square K to the power 4, where T is the temperature of the object, that is equals to 5762 Kelvin. HS is the equals to 5.67 into 10 to the power minus 8 into 5762 to the power 4, and this equals to 6.25 into 10 to the power minus 7 watt per meter square. Here L equals to 1 because we already considered the sun is the black body, so L equals to 1. Now the total radiation emitted from the sun is equals to PO equals to HS into 4 pi r square, where 4 pi r square is the surface area of the sun, and this equals to 4 pi into 6.96 into 10 to the power 8 square, and this equals to 6.08 into 10 to the power 18. So here the P equals to 6.25 into 10 to the power 7 into 6.80 into 10 to the power 18 watt, and that is equals to The final calculation is 3.8 into 10 to the power 26 watt. If the sun emits radiation, the power is emitted equally in all direction of space. As the distance from the sun increases, the power is spread over the sphere-type surfaces of increasing area. The inverse square law is used to calculate the decrease in radiation in intensity due to the increase in the distance from the sun. So, according to the inverse square law, I equals to 4 pi r square, and this r is the capital R, into hs divided by 4 pi small r square, where I is the irradiation at the surface of the outer sphere. Now, the radiant flux is given by HO equals to capital R square by small r square into hs, and this equals to 6.96 into 10 to the power 5 square divided by 1.5 into 10 to the power 8 square into 6.5 into 10 to the power 7, and this equals to finally 1346 watt per meter square. The value of the flux is calculated, is called the value of the flux is calculated by this formula and is called the solar constant. Now the average now the angular divergence del theta equals to 2 capital R by small r, and this equals to 2 into 6.96 into 10 to the power 8 divided by 1.5 into 10 to the power 11. So this equals to 0.00928 radian, and that is equals to 0.532 degree, and that is equals to 32 minutes. Now, these are the Sun-Earth relationship. So we consider this is the Sun and this is the Earth, where capital D of the Sun is 1.39 into 10 to the power 6 kilometer, and the small d of the Sun diameter is 1.27 into 10 to the power 4 kilometer, and that is the total distance between the center from the Sun to the Earth, and that is 1.5 into 10 to the power 8 kilometers. So these are the Sun-Earth relationship, and the angle is 32 minutes. Now, the Earth revolves around the Sun is elliptical orbit. Thus, the distance between the Sun and Earth varies a little throughout the year. This variation in distance produces a nearly sinusoidal variation in the intensity of the solar radiation, ISC dash, that reaches to the Earth. The value is calculated by ISC dash equals to ISC into 1 plus 0.33 cos 360 n divided by 365, where n equals to the day of the year. A term, air mass, which is denoted by AM, is represented by small m, is used as measure of the distance traveling by the beam radiation through the atmosphere before it reaches on the surface of the Earth. It is defined as the ratio of the mass of the atmosphere through which the beam radiation passes to the mass it would pass through if the Sun is directly over it at its zenith. Now, the zenith angle is denoted by theta z. Zenith angle is the angle made by the Sun's ray with the normal to the horizontal surface. The air mass is given by small m at sea level equals to 1 when the Sun is at zenith, and m equals to 2 when the zenith angle is 60 degrees. So air mass m, so the m equals to am equals to 1 by cos theta z, so this equals to sec theta z. Now these are the air mass ratio m that is equals to sec theta z diagram. So this line, this vertical line, is the normal incidence, and this angle is the zenith angle denoted by theta z, and this area is the path length increased by a factor m. Now the air mass ratio small m equals to sec theta z. So air mass m is represented by root over of 1 plus L by H square, where L is the length of shadow, H is the height of the object. So these are the height of the object and these are the length of the shadow and this is the sunlight radiations. Now, the solar radiation is depends and attenuated by the atmosphere always. The atmosphere is changed due to the temperature and other factors, like the ozone layer has strong relations with the solar ultraviolet radiation depending on the wavelength. The harmful radiation is below 280 nanometers are completely shielded by the ozone layers, because the below 280 nanometer the intensity is very high of the radiation of the rays, but the length is very short. The solar radiation is reflected and scattered by cloud, different types of particle like darts, smoke, etc., and various types of gases. The two major processes involved by the scattering are determined by the size of the molecules and particles, are known as selective scattering and non-selective scattering. The selective scattering is caused by smoke and the gas molecules, etc., and the non-selective scatterings are basically the different types of dust, etc. So non-selective scattering is caused by dust, fog, cloud, and different types of other particles, etc.